What is a polygon? Polygon is a cross two-dimensional shape where their sides are made up from straight line. Okay, let's say now if I give you a diagram. Is this a polygon? No, this is not a polygon because here you have a gap. Polygon is a cross two-dimensional shape and their sides are made up of straight line. So if I change, I cross this part with this. Is this a polygon? No, it is. Why? Because this is not a straight line. This is a curve. So this is not a polygon. So how about I chain this one, become a straight line. Is this a polygon? Yes, this is a cross two-dimensional shape and their sides are all straight line. Okay, so the minimum side, the minimum number of sides for a polygon is 3. Two sides cannot form a polygon. So I will suggest you to remember the name for the polygon which has from 3 sides to 10 sides. Okay. The 3 sides, I think it should be no problem. We call it triangle, 4 sides, quadrilateral, five sides, pentagon. Okay. 6 sides, we call it hexagon. This is heptagon, 7 side, heptagon, 8 side, we call it octagon. Okay, 2 more. This is 9 side, it's donagon. And last one, 10 side, decagon. Oops. We still have a lot. We cannot memorize all, but I would suggest you to memorize this from triangle to decagon. And you have to be more careful between these two because their spelling looks similar. This is hexagon, 6 sides. You can remember this X, S-I-X, 6. And this is heptagon, 7 sides. Okay, be careful. This one, no problem. Octagon, okay. Octopus, right? And this one, donagon, 9. Okay, so these are the name for the polygon with from 3 side to 10 side. Okay, let's learn about a little bit about the name for the part of the polygon. So here we call it vertex. Vertex. Polar form is vertices. Now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 vertices, and this is the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides. You will notice that the number of vertices is always equal to the number of sides. See, now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 vertices, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides. How about this one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 vertices, and we have how many sides? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sides. Okay, and now one is a diagonal. So diagonal, when you draw a line, connect from one vertex to another vertex. Oops. When you draw a line, connect the one vertex from another vertex to another vertex. This one is called diagonal. Diagonal, okay, let me label it here. Diagonal. Okay, so we need to know how many diagonal of a polygon has. Okay, for a triangle, we don't have, triangle doesn't have any diagonal. So how about quadrilateral? We have one diagonal, two diagonal, right? So the number of diagonal here, we have two. Okay, how about this one? So one, two, three, four, five. Okay, let me check around. Not five diagonal. Okay, this one, let me make it a little bit clearer. Number of diagonal. So this is two. This number of diagonal. This is five. Okay, actually we have a formula to help us calculate the number diagonal. The formula is n minus 3 n multiplied by n minus 3 divided by 2. Okay, let me try. How to use this formula to help us to get the number of diagonal? According to this formula, n is a number of sides. So here we have how many sides? 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 sides, right? So the number of diagonal will be 4 times 4 minus 3 divided by 2. Okay, just press the calculator. 4 times 1 divided by 2, you get 2. The number of diagonal is 2. How about this one? Now we have how many sides here? 1, 2, how many vertices or how many sides? They are equal. So remember, number of vertices and number of sides are the same. Okay, so this is 5. 5 times 5 minus 3 divided by 2. Okay. 5 times 10, you get, 5 times 2, you get 10. And divided by 2, 5. Okay? So if we want to determine the number of diagonal of a hexagon, this n is equal to 6. So it will be n times, it will be 6 times 6 minus 3 divided by 2. 6 times 3 divided by 2, we get 9. Okay, how about this one? Heptagon, the n is equal to 7. 7 times 7 minus 3 divided by 2. It is 7 times 4 divided by 2, 14. Okay, this way how we calculate the number of diagonal of a polygon. Okay, let's learn one more thing. Axis of symmetry. So just now you have learned about vertex, right? And ruler form is the vertices and the side and the diagonal. Now we go to learn about the axis of symmetry. Axis of symmetry. Okay, so a quadrilateral, this is a square. Okay, a square. We have how many axes of symmetry? It can be here. Can be here. It can be here. And it can be here. Means that when you fold up this shape along this all line, the side will perfectly overlap each other. Okay, let me try explain to you if use this one. So one of the axes of symmetry, okay, we just assume that this is a equilateral triangle. Means that when you fold up this shape along this straight line, this side and this side will overlap each other perfectly. So this is one of the axes of symmetry of this equilateral triangle. Another one will be here. And it can be here also. Okay. So let's say if this is a regular polygon. So what is a regular polygon? This you will learn more in Form 2. Regular polygon. Regular polygon is a polygon which every side same length and every interior angle here same size. We call it regular polygon. So if the given polygon is a regular polygon and the question asks you how many axes of symmetry does polygon have, it's very easy. You don't have to draw like this one by one and calculate. If there are three sides or three vertices, 1, 2, 3, we have three axes of symmetry. If we have four vertices, 1, 2, 3, 4, then the polygon will have four axes of symmetry. So how about this one? I give you a rectangle. Draw a rectangle first. Okay. Let's say you have a rectangle. How many axes of symmetry does a rectangle have? Four vertices, right? Four axes of symmetry? No, it's not correct. So we try to draw it. We have one axis of symmetry here. And we have another one, which is over here. Only two axes of symmetry. Just now I told you that the number of axes of symmetry is equal to the number of vertices of a polygon, right? But that is only applied for regular polygon, remember. Regular polygon means that all the sides same length, all this interior angle, this one we call it interior angle. All the interior angle are the same size. So this one, yes, interior angle same size, 90 degrees, but the problem is the length, the side length, this and this equal and this diff another length. So this is actually not a regular polygon. Okay, so for a regular polygon, the number of axes of symmetry is equal to the number of vertices. This only apply for a regular polygon, remember. So if I ask you, how many, this is a regular hexagon, this is pentagon, regular pentagon. So I ask you, how many axes of symmetry does this regular pentagon have? You don't have to draw, there must be five. There's five vertices, right? Okay, let's try to draw it. Okay, let me try to draw it. See whether we can get five axes of symmetry or not. Okay, one is over here. Here, one. Two. Three. Four. Five. So we have five axes of symmetry, correct? Okay. So remember, in this video, you learn about the number of vertices, the name, vertex, side, and the name for a few types of polygon, remember it, and diagonal, the number of diagonal, the formula, and the number of axes of symmetry. See you in the next video. Bye bye.